गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 4, मॉड्यूल 4, एयर। सी, लेट्स डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट साइक्लोन, दैट इज नेचुरल फ्यूरी। Orissa, located on the eastern seacoast of India, is prone to cyclones that originate in Bay of Bengal. On 17 and 18 October 1999, cyclone hit 5 districts of the state. Another super cyclone occurred on the 29th October 1999 that devastated large portions of the state. The damages caused were mainly due to 3 factors: wind velocity, rain and tidal surge. The winds of up to 260 kilometers per hour lasted for over 36 hours. These high velocity winds uprooted trees and damaged the kacha houses. Rooftop of several industrial sheds and other houses were also blown away. Power supply and telecom lines snapped completely. Heavy rain occurred under the influence of cyclone for 3 days continuously. These rains led to flooding in the major rivers of Orissa. The cyclonic winds caused tidal waves that swept 20 kilometers inland and brought massive destruction to the coastal areas. The 7 to 10 meter high tidal wave intruded suddenly and caused massive damage to the standing paddy crops. The cyclone originated as a depression in the Gulf of Thailand near east of Port Blair on 25th October 1999 and gradually moved in a northwestward direction. It intensified into a supercyclone and hit the area between Erasama and Baliguda in Odisha on 29th October at 10:30 a.m. The supercyclone swept entire the coast of Odisha, including the cities of Bhubaneswar and Cuttack and 28 coastal towns. About 30 million people were affected. A large number of livestock were killed. Standing crops of paddy, vegetables and fruits were heavily damaged. Due to the salination caused by the tidal surge, large tracts of agriculture and land have turned infertile. Large tracts of salt, teak and bamboo plantation have disappeared. The mangrove forest between Paradip and Konark vanished. The next we need to discuss about moisture. When water evaporates from land and different water bodies, it becomes water vapor. Moisture in the air at any time is known as humidity. When the air is full of water vapor, we call it as humid day. As the air gets warmer, its capacity to hold the water vapor increases, and so it becomes more and more humid. On a humid day, clothes take longer to dry, and sweat from our body does not evaporate easily, making us feel very uncomfortable. When the water vapor rises, it starts cooling. The water vapor condenses, causing formation of droplet of water. Clouds are just masses of such water droplets. When these droplets of water become too heavy to float in air, then they come down as precipitation. Jet planes flying in the sky leave a white trail behind them. The moisture from their engines condenses. We see trails of this condensed moisture for some time when there is no air movement to disturb it. Precipitation that comes down to the earth in liquid form is called rain. Most of the groundwater comes from rainwater. Plants help preserve water. When trees on hillsides are cut, rainwater flows down the bare mountain and can cause flooding of the low-lying areas. On the base of mechanism, there are 3 types of rainfall: the convectional rainfall, the orographic rainfall and the cyclonic rainfall. Rainfall is very important for the survival of the plants and animals. It brings fresh water to the earth's surface. If rainfall is less, water scarcity and drought occur. On the other hand, if it is more, floods take place. Then other forms of precipitation are snow, sleet, and hail. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.